Welcome at tutorial number 41 of the EEP10 Model Railway Simulator. In the previous video we have been working on our project for the two-track turnout with a control circuit, and we built all the block signaling to protect our circuit against collisions. Well, let's put that to the test. We are going to place a train and drive around to see if all the signals work properly. So let's open up the program, and if you are building with me and you open the last saved file, then this is what we should have. Over here, if I zoom in, we have the signaling for the two-track junction. This is track, well, let me first show you where what we were doing again. This was track A, the top track going right to left. That makes a loop over here and it returns as track D, and then the outer loop over here is A again. So we have one route, so to say, that is called A and D. Then we also have a track B that goes straight here, and that it makes here this inner curve to track C, and then it returns over here to B. So we also have a route called BC. Did we already create those routes? I think we did in the previous video, but if we did not, then we are going to do that. No, we did. See, route AD and a route BC. So I can assign these routes to the trains I am going to place. Also, what we did, if we go to Weiche mode and I click this Weiche, we see that we have placed two sensors, one for AD and one for BC, to switch this junction. That's the only junction that makes the distinction. Okay, let us place a train. Well, let's first make an overview camera somewhere over here. East camera, east, that overlooks the whole area. How did we do that? We click the camera icon, then we hit the control key on the keyboard to give it a height, and then a direction, and then, well, we have not exactly what I wanted, but more or less what is already quite nice. And then with the control and the shift arrow keys, I rotate around a bit and move a bit so that I get the whole area in view. And then I can call this camera east. Well, this is okay. Maybe a little bit of more of a rotation, and a bit this, and zoom in a little bit, and I have a camera that I'm going to save as camera east, and it has the complete overview. New camera. Okay, well, let's place a rolling stock over here. Zoom in a little bit on track D, and that turns into track A. I'm going to place our famous orange diesel lock. So roll material, baan, normal spoor, and then diesel locks. Where is it? Over here. And then I have to find it. Yes, that is this one. Yes, that is our lock, and I'm going to call it A. Okay, it is placed. I'm also going to place a few orange passenger cars. Well, I quickly scroll through the list to find those. Yeah, over here. Okay, place one over here. I don't care about the name. And one over there. I don't care about the name. And now we are going to pick them up. Well, first of all, this lock has to drive backwards, and these connect icons should be lit. And well, let's have it give it a little backward speed. Oop, not too hard, too fast. It should connect automatically. And then I can hit the S on the keyboard to stop it. What I am going to do, I click this car, this locomotive again. I'm going to, it is locomotive A, that is correct. I come to put it on track AD, on route AD. And what I'm going to do now is simply have the camera view. Well, first I have to give it a speed, and then we are going to have a look with the camera on the train if all our sensors, signals are switched okay. Well, that one it obviously never saw, because it was already, it was placed on the track just before that. This signal is going to be controlled. Let me rotate a bit. This one is going to be controlled by our control circuit. the opening and the closing of that. The closing is automatic, but the opening is done by the control circuit. This is a normal block signal that should normally be open if there is no train ahead. It, you see, it automatically closes, so that is good. And it should also open again. This is also a normal block signal that is open if there is no train in the next block. And it also automatically closes. Yes, that also looks good. Then the next signal is also a block, a normal block signal that should be open. I tried to click it on a moving screen. Yeah, I did. It should be open if there is no train in that block, just like there is not now. So it also closes very good. And this is a signal that is done by the control circuit. Hey, I see that this guy did not automatically close. Let's go to our signal system. Why does did guy not close? That is strange. Okay, let's have a look what does this guy say. Yeah, it says it should close and it is for signal 6. So I don't know why that did not happen. I don't understand. Well, maybe it looks okay, but somehow it did not work. I don't know why. Did I do something by hand? I don't know. Okay, the train is on track A and D. This is track D, this is the deviation. Yes, that signal closes automatically. And this signal is open and it should now close automatically. Yeah, that already happened. And then I am coming to the signal that is before the junction, and that is switched by our control circuit that we do not yet have, but I do that manually now. It closes automatically. And now I want to have a look at this guy. It's a normal block signal. It should close, but it did not. I don't know. Yes, it closed. Well, then there was probably a misunderstanding with me. All the other signals have also opened again automatically, which is good. That was our block signaling. It closes automatically as soon as the train has passed, but it opens again automatically as soon as the train has passed the next signal. And we have seen now that it works. I'm going to put the train now on the other route, BC, so that we are going to run straight on as soon as we are at our junction, so that we can have one test, final test of that loop. I open up the gate already. Oops, I cannot touch it. Yes. Oh, this one is again open. Oh, that is of course because it is a normal block signal. Is the train going straight? Yes, it is. This is a normal block, should be open. So the junction is working correct, the train is running good, the signals are all doing good. Well, I think this manual testing with one train has proved its use. It confused myself, but we have been building it so well in the previous video that it all seemed to work. Okay, this is the signal that is going to be controlled by the control circuit that we are going to build in the next video. Let me put this train to a halt over here. I manually close that one. And then we are satisfied with the first test of our track. All the block signaling seems to work well. And also the route allocation seems to work well. Oh, this was train. I called it train A, so I am going to put it on the route AD. Yeah, just so that we have some logic. Okay, let's save this file. I'll do that outside the video. And see you back in the next video where we are going to build the control circuit.